I was wrong about ReZero. Watching ReZero Season 2 has made me realize something very important, that your experiences with media and storytelling can change over time, that no matter how set in stone you thought your opinions were before, it's possible to see something in a different light that elevates it more than some of its parts. If you told me a few years ago that ReZero would be one of my favorite anime in modern times, I would have laughed. But yet, here I am making this video because I genuinely believe that ReZero has become something truly special that the anime community has yet to truly appreciate. At its surface, ReZero presents itself as a fairly conventional isekai, with the main character Natsuki Subaru having a unique ability that allows him to reset the world every time he dies. And just from this premise alone, the series plants an inherent idea towards the viewer about what the story is going to be about. Many people, including my past self, had this expectation that the overall narrative would revolve around Subaru and how he had to overcome conflicts within the story using his new ability. Maybe he would have to outsmart his opponents or manipulate the people around him using his superior knowledge. In essence, the majority of people expected and viewed ReZero as a plot-driven story where its primary focus was on the action and a well-constructed narrative. You don't have to look very far for people criticizing the show's narrative or internal logic. Comments like these can be found abundantly online in any discussion of the series. However, this is where I think there seems to be a fundamental misunderstanding about what ReZero is actually about. And from my personal experience of the show, I think I can provide context of why that is and show how ReZero has become a truly profound story of self-discovery. Back in 2016, when I initially watched the first season, I made a video titled The Problems with ReZero, in which I voiced my opinions and criticism of the show in numerous aspects, both what I thought was good and not so good. To give a quick summary of my thoughts back then, my main problems with the show were that there were essentially no stakes in the story because Subaru could just reset the world to get a timeline where everything just went his way. At other times, the show just felt like it was torturing Subaru just for the sake of suffering, with each death getting more and more drastic. And finally, Subaru himself was at times borderline insufferable because of the way he acted towards Emilia and how much he made a fool of himself. With all these aspects compounded against each other, it was difficult to see just where the heart of the series lied. I don't hold the same opinions of the show as I did back then. Looking back now with hindsight, I don't blame myself, or anyone for that matter, to hold opinions similar to the ones I once held a few years ago. I still think that those criticisms are still valid for anyone who still holds them, but to only view that interpretation as the only correct one is dead wrong and intellectually dishonest. ReZero was never a plot-driven story, no matter how much it disguised itself as one. It was, and always has been, a personal character study. Once you view the series through this lens, it becomes clear what the overarching messages and themes of the story are. It was never about how Subaru would have to overcome the villains he faced and win over the girl he loved. It was in fact about how Subaru learned to become a better person. ReZero is a character study about self-discovery, and this is where I think many people fail to see or misunderstand what the point of the series is. So today, I want to bring to light the true underlying ethos of ReZero and show you just how profoundly special this story really is. Spoilers for Season 2. The inciting incident to this season is having Rem erased from everyone's memories except for Subaru. And try as he might, no matter how many times he returns by death, he's never able to save the girl who saw him as her hero. This makes Subaru blame himself for what happened as he carries the weight of one of his most precious friends. Subaru has never been more alone than in this instance. The person who had previously saved him from himself is now gone. And despite having the power to change the world, Subaru can do nothing. He believes that all of this is his fault and shoulders the burden by himself. But Emilia reminds Subaru that he's not alone, and that you shouldn't be forced to carry the weight of responsibility by yourself. You have other people who care about your well-being, and in return will share your lowest moments.
スバルが助けてくれたみたいに、今度は私もスバルを助けたい。 Subaru が傷ついているなら、何とかしてあげたい。
In a show that throws the audience into a fantasy world filled with witches, deadly creatures, and other mysteries, the most cathartic episode doesn't come from any thrilling or bombastic action-packed sequence, but a slow, reflective episode where characters just talk about how they feel. It's one of the most emotionally poignant and cathartic episodes of ReZero, as we get to truly empathize and understand what Subaru had been through all this time. This is the one singular episode that I would point to for anyone who doesn't understand what the series is about. As Subaru's eccentric father, Kenichi, begins the episode by waking his son up, we can see that Subaru's room is littered with anime figures and manga, telling us that he's an otaku, much like the people watching this series. After having what can be described as a weird breakfast, it becomes clear what the underlying issue is. Subaru is a hikikomori, a shut-in, who doesn't attend school, doesn't have any friends, and doesn't do anything. He's given up on life and just stays in his room, waiting for the days to go by. His mentality has gotten to the point where he's convinced himself that his life is utterly worthless. For Subaru, there didn't seem to be much point in him continuing to live his life. He had, for the most part, already given up on it. I'm sure many of us at some point in our lives have felt the same way, that in the grand scheme of things, our lives didn't matter. We didn't see ourselves as anything special, and in return, failed to appreciate the things around us. Having a warped and negative perception about yourself is brutal as you slowly, over time, start to belittle and think of yourself as worthless. If you yourself believe that you don't deserve to live, then how can you believe that others want to help you? Subaru wanted his parents to get angry at him so that he could validate to himself that his life was meaningless, that no one cared about him. But his parents never did that, even though he wanted them to. All his mother and father ever did was try to support their son as best they can. They never blamed Subaru for losing sight of himself and were accepting of the fact that their precious son was going through a difficult time in his life. When he was younger, Subaru excelled in sports and academics. He thought that he was the best in everything that he did, so much so that there was an expectation placed on him being the son of the great Kenichi Natsuki, and from that point on, Subaru lived in the shadow of his father. When you have that much pressure placed on yourself to do well, you don't want to disappoint the people who place those expectations. But in the long run, it can lead to a worse mentality and have devastating effects on how you choose to perceive yourself. You're constantly being compared to someone else, and you feel as if you don't have your own self-identity. You begin to do things not because you want to, but because it's expected of you. And if you don't live up to those high expectations, you're seen as a lesser person, causing yourself to doubt your own abilities. You begin to criticize yourself. Why am I not good enough? Why can't I do this? And after a while, it takes a toll on you. You begin to realize that you're not worthy of other people's expectations, and this leads you down a dark path where you believe that you can't do anything, so what's the point in trying? This is the mindset that Subaru had, and I'm sure many of us can relate and empathize with. It's hard to deal with life when you view so little of yourself and have no self-worth. The only thing that can get you out is if you can change the opinion you have of yourself, which seems impossible. In the first season, when Subaru had just been transported into a fantasy world, he relishes the fact that he can now start over. And this isn't because he was excited to explore the world around him, but because he had already given up on life in the real world. He never wanted to go back there. In this fantasy, he could start over again, not having to worry about what others thought of him. He could go anywhere, do anything, and be the hero of his own idealistic story. But that's not what the series is about. The point of the first season wasn't to explore this new fantasy setting or showcase the suffering that Subaru had went through. It was about presenting Subaru's worst character traits and how he needed a change in order to become a better person. Throughout his journey, Subaru, in the back of his mind, always thought of himself as the lowest of society. He was selfish, arrogant, and didn't want to understand the feelings of those around him. This in turn pushed everyone away from him, and by episode 18 of the series, he was left alone. ready to completely give up on life just as he did in the real world. But things were different this time. Just as Subaru lays out everything he hated about himself, Rem showed him just how much he was a hero to her. It didn't matter what Subaru had thought of himself, for Rem, he was her knight in shining armor, a person who saved her. It's through her supportive and loving words that Rem was able to save Subaru from himself, and by the end of the first season, Subaru was able to become someone worthy to stand as equals with those around him, and finally genuinely connect with Emilia. Episode 4 of the second season encapsulates this character journey that Subaru had gone through by making him reflect on his past actions and realizing how wrong he truly was. In the past, Subaru thought of himself as trash who didn't deserve to live a happy life, and this made him truly believe that no one cared about him. But Subaru failed to see just how supportive his parents were. No matter if he was doing well at school, became a delinquent, or a shut-in, his parents never treated him differently. Through subtle acts and gestures, they tried to help Subaru from the dark pit he was in. Although, ultimately, the only one who could pick himself back up was Subaru himself from the support of others. Through introspection and reflection, Subaru was able to realize his self-destructive mindset and break away from it. During his lowest moments in life, Subaru was unable to appreciate all the support his loving parents gave him. He thought so little of his own self-worth that he tricked himself into believing that no one cared about him, when in reality, that wasn't true. Having this kind of mindset is difficult, and breaking away from it is even harder. You start to believe that the whole world is against you, and so slowly your mind considers that giving up entirely may not be so bad. But time and time again throughout the course of the series, giving up has never been the right choice. ReZero's messages isn't a cruel story about dealing with suffering and being unable to escape from it. It's a hopeful beacon of light where people can choose to pick themselves back up no matter how far you've fallen. When you're in pain, suffering by yourself, and you feel as if no one is there for you, it can lead your mind to a lot of dark places as you begin to convince yourself that no one and nothing can help you. It's a terrifying feeling of isolation where nobody could possibly understand what you're going through. And this can lead you to giving up entirely as you begin to suffocate and feel trapped from the world around. Giving up may be your only option left. But as the series has shown, giving up is easy. Running away from your problems will never change you to become a better person. You'll stagnate in life and continue the cycle of self-hatred, never learning from your past mistakes. ReZero believes that confronting your problems head-on is the only way forward. But that doesn't mean you have to do it all alone. Getting help from others may be seen as a weakness because you feel too useless and inadequate to solve your own problems, but that's not the right way to think. It shouldn't be seen as a weakness, but a strength of character as you start to open up and become vulnerable to the people around you. Sometimes your personal problems can be too big to handle all by yourself, and that's okay. Relying on others is a sign of trust and conveys just how deep your bonds are with them. People want to help each other in times of need, and accepting that help just reaffirms your relationship as you can do the same in return. You should never believe that no one cares for you because even if one person does, it's possible to make a change. It's never too late to want to live. What matters isn't how you start or what happens in the middle. It's how it ends. Those are the words that Subaru's mother utters to him, and it's so profoundly impactful. It not only serves as an encapsulation of his character, but as a microcosm of the entire series. It's impossible to go through life having everything figured out. You'll stumble along the way, make mistakes, and maybe even drive yourself into a corner where escape seems far, far away. But it's through these failures and mistakes where you can learn from your past experiences and carve out the best future ahead of you. In this episode, Subaru finally learns to be appreciative of what he had, a loving mother and father who cared so much about their son but were unable to do anything for him. Subaru realizes how much of a burden he's been for them and that he's done nothing to ever show his gratitude, which is what makes this episode so bittersweet. Subaru can no longer thank or even talk to his real parents, but it's through his mother's words that he'll never forget them. Throughout the season of ReZero, in terms of progressing the actual narrative, nothing seems to actually get accomplished. The villagers are stuck in the sanctuary, unable to leave due to mysterious circumstances, and back at the mansion, a surprise attack awaits the people who Subaru cares for. He's in a tough place, stuck between freeing the sanctuary and saving the people precious to him. This season spends a lot of time building problems on top of problems for Subaru, and it can feel absolutely overwhelming. While Subaru has learned to overcome his own self-hatred and pity, this season presents a whole new set of obstacles that Subaru has to overcome and challenges his character in different ways than the previous season. When something goes horribly wrong and Subaru finds himself in a timeline that isn't ideal, the first instinct that he has is to end his life. While it does make sense logically that Subaru can give up his life to achieve a future he wants, it's far from a healthy mindset and even destructive to his own person. For Subaru, dying in order to save a loved one may be one of the easiest choices he has to make. His power of return by death is what has defined his character all throughout the series. Without it, he wouldn't be able to solve any of his problems, or so he thinks. Subaru is fine with taking up all the pain and suffering of each failed loop, if it means that he can, by the end, save all the people he loves. But ReZero shows us that Subaru dying over and over again while trying to shoulder all the suffering of the people he cares for isn't the right choice. He's convinced himself that if anyone should die, it has to be him, without even considering the feelings of everyone else around him. Through every single loop, Subaru believes that he is the only one who can save them. But with every failed attempt, it becomes evident that his way of thinking can never be the correct one. Subaru dies because he cares about the people around him and suffers on their behalf, but what he doesn't realize is that those same people care for him the same way he does for them. Frederica, Petra, Otto, and so many others will gladly lay their life on the line just to save him. The second trial that Subaru has to go through is all about teaching him that he should learn to value his own life. To throw your own life away just because things don't go your way and have it be taken for granted is horrifying, especially to those that you left behind. In the second trial, Subaru gets to experience the aftermath of every failed loop and to see those people that love and care for him in even more pain. He sees that just because he had taken all of their physical pain away by dying, their emotional pain is much more intense. Just because Subaru has good intentions doesn't mean that his way of doing things is the correct way forward, and upon realizing this, everything that Subaru has done this season seems all for naught. He's back to square one, not having a clue on how to handle all of these overwhelming situations, and it becomes incredibly lonely to deal with. All throughout the whole season, Echidna is painted as a character in which Subaru could talk to and get advice from. She's been watching him all this time and knows what Subaru has gone through. After failing over and over again, dying in the most painful ways imaginable, Subaru feels lost in what to do. But Echidna comforts him, and Subaru realizes that in her ethereal tea party, he can finally talk about the one thing he couldn't do before. Subaru's power of return by death has many advantages going for it, but what's never brought up is the toll for the one using it. All this time, Subaru could never talk about the one important thing and has to live with the knowledge that no one could ever understand what he's going through. It's painfully scary and undoubtedly lonely for him. So when he finds out that he's able to tell Echidna about this, Subaru breaks down into tears. He had been carrying this weight alone for so long with no one in sight, and when he's finally able to let it all out, it's cathartic. Echidna isn't just able to hear what Subaru has to say, but the fact that she saw his long, arduous journey all this time and can comfort and empathize with Subaru makes him trust her. This is the one person in Subaru's life so far that he's able to be completely honest with and lay bare all of his pent-up emotions. It's no wonder then, by the end of the first part of this season, Subaru considers her offer. After all, everything he's done to try and solve the problems ahead of him have all miserably failed. But to accept her offer would mean that Subaru would be living his life through the lens and expectations of someone else, something that had completely destroyed his life not too long ago. So what's the answer then? What can Subaru do so that he knows for a fact that he can achieve a future where everything is all right in the end? The answer is, there isn't one, and that's just life. No person can tell you or promise you how to live your life so that you can achieve everything that you want. Life just doesn't work that way. But it's not an excuse to give up. Everyone in their own way will make mistakes. Things will go wrong, and at times, life will be extremely difficult. It's normal to feel anxious about yourself and the things around, but it's with the love and support of those around you can you begin to move forward. Relying on others, especially your friends, is what friends are for. You help each other in times of need. Even if you don't know what the answer to your problems are, it's important to talk about them with the people who care for you, so that together you can both find the answer. Subaru finally realizes that he doesn't have to do everything by himself. Through Otto's encouraging words, he's able to find the answer that he had been looking for all this time. If you find yourself lost and don't know what the right path forward is, you should talk to the people who care about you. They might not know what the correct path forward is either, but with their help, you can take comfort in the fact that you don't have to do it all alone. Just as you shared the happiest moments with them, you shouldn't need to deal with your lowest moments by yourself. You can share the burden because that's what a genuine bond is. With a newfound resolve, Subaru now seems ready to tackle any obstacle in his way, but in his time of self-reflection, there was a person who was even more lonely and anxious than he was. Emilia, on the outset, has always been portrayed as a model person who's kind and always tries to understand the people around her. She always puts on a smile on her face even during hard times and tries to think in a positive way. She's portrayed as an almost perfect character in contrast to Subaru, with selfless desires and motivations. But slowly, through the second season of ReZero, we start to see how the series chips away at the notion that Emilia is a perfect person. I think Subaru's confession to Emilia is ReZero's most important message for anyone watching the series. The episode A Reason to Believe stands as a pillar for hope for anyone who doesn't think highly of themselves, and is the culmination of everything the story has been building up to. ReZero has always been about a series that portrays the inner anxieties of characters and their worst traits. Every person harbors negative thoughts and feelings about themselves, that they're not good enough, or that you don't deserve to be happy because you're a burden to those around you. Subaru, for the longest time, always saw Emilia as a faultless angel and put her on a pedestal of being this model and perfect person. Comparing the visuals from the beginning of the series up till now makes it clearly evident that Emilia isn't a flawless person. No one is. The series shows us that even the person who you believed all this time to be perfect doesn't view themselves the same way that you do. But it's how, despite those negative feelings and emotions you have about yourself, you're allowed to love yourself and have others love you in return. Because even if you don't believe in yourself, or that you consider yourself to be worthless, there are people who believe in you, and that's just as valid as anything. All this time, Emilia has always been reliant on those around her, and without the people she cares for being with her, she lacks the confidence in herself, constantly believing that she's not good enough to accomplish anything on her own. She feels as if she's a burden to those around her and believes that the reason why everyone she's ever loved always seems to leave is because of her own existence. If you can't believe in yourself, then how can you believe that the people around you do? Emilia's past is tragic, and after Puck had left, her memories of the past had slowly been coming back to her. She's afraid to relive the memories because it might confirm her worst thoughts about herself, that she was the one to drive everyone away. This of course turned out to be false, but before taking on the first trial, Emilia truly believed that she was the one to cause all the bad things happening in her life. In the past, Subaru would idealize Emilia to be a perfect person, but the truth is, no one is perfect. No such person exists. ReZero shows us that it's okay to have parts of ourselves that we dislike or think is ugly, but it's through self-love and the love of others can we continue to better ourselves. Subaru's confession to Emilia parallels Rem's confession to him back during the first season. In this instance, Emilia was just like Subaru back then. She had pent-up anxieties about herself and had so little self-worth. But just as Rem saved him in the past, Subaru now saves Emilia from herself. It's come full circle. This is what ReZero is all about. It's not a plot-driven story, but a profound, cathartic character study about how you can learn to love yourself and those around you so that you can continue to be the best version of yourself. It's really comforting to know that a series I had initially written off can now become a part of my favorites, and I have ReZero to thank for that. If you still find yourself or anyone wondering what the point of ReZero is, show them this video. It might just make them gain a new perspective. This video is the longest I've ever made and took a lot of time, so if you enjoyed it, I would be extremely grateful if you shared it around and subscribed. Thank you so much, and I'll see you all next time.